Jacob.
And this is the RAM report
of 2K16.
What are you doing?
Nathan, do you ever dream of traveling across the country with some of your closest friends?
Not with the Zodiac Killer around.
You mean Ted Cruz? Anywho, a bunch of Sea Valley kids actually did get to live their traveling dream this past April without any casualties. Let's hand it over to Bill Clinton for more information.
I encourage students all across our country to get involved in Close Up and involved in America.
Thanks, Mr. President, for the wise words. Now let's see what the Close Up kids are up to.
So, what do you expect to get out of Close Up?
I expect to see a lot of memorials and get a closer view of Washington, D.C.
I'm super excited for Close Up.
Get pumped.
Eleven ravishing students traveled cross-country to experience this Washington, D.C. program. Every day we saw new monuments and participated in debates with our fellow workshop members. Our trip was also filled with museums, plays, and conversing with our own Senators Murkowski and Dan Sullivan.
My favorite part about Close Up was the Iwo Jima Memorial. It was a very beautiful statue, and it was also a very famous photo from World War II. It was awesome.
I believe Close Up gave me a broader knowledge of other people's opinions. You know, living in a small town, you only get to see one or two, but Close Up exposed me to opinions from all over the country, and I was able to see why they had certain beliefs that I didn't agree with. And I was able to change their minds, I felt like, in some ways. And there were several debates in which people did not agree. And we were able to make points where kids would kind of understand. And the same went the other way around. I understood what they were saying. And sometimes I changed my views. So it was really awesome.
Thanks again, President Clinton, for the wise words.
As the weather is heating up, so is our track season. Let's hand it over to Parker to see how those runners are doing.
What events are you doing?
I am doing discus and shot put.
Have you been to any meets yet?
I have not been to any meets yet. Hopefully soon. Working on getting my grades up so I can, but I'll make the school proud. Maybe.
When's the next meet?
The next track meet is next Friday and Saturday at Colony High School, Colony Invitational.
Will there be a home meet?
Yes, there is a home meet the weekend after the Sioux Valley Invite, and then the weekend after that is our Region 2 Championships, and that's a Friday-Saturday meet.
Do you have any potential in kids?
Absolutely. Yeah, we've got some really good throwers. Marshall and Aiden and Frauke are throwing really good, and Stephen Kreppel's doing great in distance, and Haley Loper's doing good in high jump, so is Cairo. We've got a pretty good team this year.
Man, have you noticed how the Zika virus is making kids' heads smaller and smaller each year?
Nathan, I don't think that's the Zika virus. I think that's just the sixth graders.
Whoa.
Yeah, let's refresh your memory and take it over to Caitlin.
Hi, I'm Caitlin, and you may be wondering, what's up with all the sixth graders in Sioux Valley all of a sudden? Or even, how has the sixth graders changed Sioux Valley? Well, I'm going to answer that for you.
Well, it all started early last year, when our school district decided to bring the sixth graders from Willow, Trapper Creek, and Talkeetna to our school. Many people did not want the sixth graders coming to our school, so the school district decided that it would be the parents' choice to send their child to the elementary school or to Sioux Valley.
Overall, how did the sixth graders change Sioux Valley? Well, let's ask some people.
Do you like having the sixth graders here?
I don't really mind it. I mean, kind of like it better when they weren't here, but that's just an opinion because my little sister's here, so.
Do you think that your lunch period is more crowded?
At the orientation, it was definitely really crowded, but now that all the sixth graders kind of found their own cliques to get in with and stuff, it's not that crowded.
Tamara Henderson is the new sixth grade teacher. She came to us as a transfer from Talkeetna Elementary. At the time of this report, she is down in Kachemak Bay helping her sixth grade students learn about marine ecosystems. So far, the biggest problems for the sixth grade students seems to be figuring out how to open their lockers. Otherwise, they have been a nice addition to the Sioux Valley Ramley.
Thank you, Kaya, for letting me interview you. And back to you, Cassidy and Jacob.
The senioritis is thick in this school this year.
But luckily, on the senior trip, they got to shred some sick napow on the Mount His House.
Early one Monday morning, the Sioux Valley seniors left on a trip down to Alyeska Resort. There was a feeling of excitement in the air as the bus pulled out of the parking lot, then quickly turned back because we forgot Tawny. After that, however, it was smooth sailing until we reached Alyeska, and that's when everything went from great to amazing. After receiving passes and gear, seniors were quick to head up to Chair 7 to learn how to snowboard and ski. However, the rain drove many seniors indoors to check out the pool and hot tub. The few who chose to stay rode until the lifts closed for the day. The rest of the night was spent mostly at the pool or watching movies together. The next day, it was on to Get Air in Anchorage, where seniors spent an hour bouncing on the trampolines, completing the Ninja Warrior course, doing tricks into the foam pit, and even playing a class-wide game of dodgeball. And now, let's hear from some seniors.
Best part of senior trip? Probably Get Air. I think everyone had a really fun time there. Trampolines were pretty sick. Yeah, I think doing flips and stuff was great. I don't think anyone had a bad time there.
My most favorite part about going on the senior trip was riding the SkyTram all the way to the top. It was my first time and I'm kind of scared of heights, so it was a fun trip.
Brought the class together. I think that, you know, as we're getting older, we're supposed to be told that we're supposed to be adults and stuff. You know, we're trying to like get ready for life and college and stuff. I think that the senior trip reminded us that it's okay to like be kids and stuff and have fun. I think that's really the most important part. It was a time for everyone to cut loose and have a good time.
I think what brought the class mostly together was when we went and had fun in the pool and we took lots of group photos together under the water. That was that and the hot tub. I think that's what brought us together the most.
So Cassidy, I've heard you've been making a video on socialism lately.
Not quite. It's more about socializing at school.
Oh, let's take a look at that. We'll be right back.
school and why?
I think it is important. It helps bring students together and makes a closer, knit, happier school.
I think that socializing at school with everyone is a really good thing, so you can be friends with everyone in the school.
Do you think that time spent outside of class socializing is more or less important than time spent in class?
I don't think it's more important, but it's definitely pretty important. You can't just school someone for 8 hours a day and then not let them relax and talk to their friends.
I think in class is pretty important time, but it's always nice to
retirement.
I'm probably going to go out and buy me a nice pair of boat shoes.
You mean goat shoes?
Is that a pun because Ms. Hogan is retiring this year?
Maybe.
She has realistic expectations for her kids.
She's one of my favorite teachers. Pretty much my favorite teacher.
Was a great teacher.
It's really cute.
Is super genuine and is extremely understanding.
Embraces the moment and brightens up every day.
I love her so much.
Oh, Brenda Hogan? Yeah, she's pretty much a badass. When I first came to Sioux Valley, she was one of the teachers who was super welcoming, helped me transition to the new school. She gave me all kinds of pro tips on teaching remedial math, shared a bunch of important information about Sioux Valley students. Just made me feel welcome. She's obviously super intelligent, neat, organized, friendly, and these are just a few of the characteristics I think that make her such an amazing teacher. Brenda, we're really gonna miss you. Have fun in retirement, and we'll try not to be too jealous. Best wishes for the future.
And this has been The Ram Report.
Thank you for watching.